Okay, here we go, YouTube. I'm gonna plug this into my 220 volt outlet.
That's reading 246 volts, 0 watts, 100 milliamps. Let me reset the camera so we can plug in a 220 volt load. Okay, I've got my milling machine plugged in. It's, I think, around 1.5, 2 horsepower, and I'll turn it on here. Let's see what it reads. Wow, there we go. About 400 watts, 5 amps. Actually, that doesn't take as much as I thought it did. Okay, this is my MillerMatic 175. I'll just have it on idle here. So we kick it on. That's not too much power. 44 watts just on idle. Well, let me see. Maybe I can run a bead here and just see what the current goes up to. So let me set up for doing that. Okay, so I won't be able to see the camera while I'm welding here. So let's run a little bead here, see what happens. Okay, so yeah, we can take a look at that, see how much power this welder takes. Shut it off and we can go take a look at the video. The only thing it doesn't do is power factor. You could compute power factor just by taking the volts times the amps to get you the volt amps. So if you divide the watts by the volt amps, that's your power factor. Okay, YouTube, I've made one small change to my 240 volt split phase kilowatt meter. What I've done is I've taken the power that feeds the panel meter and I've run that black wire from the incoming power connection there down through the current transformer and then over to the meter. So what that does is it's taking the current that's feeding the meter here and running it backwards through the current transformer, essentially doing a subtraction. So you have current coming in on the main power wire, and then you've got a little bit of current going back to power the meter. And since this meter has a capacitive dropper power supply inside, it's going to pull a fair bit of current. It's reactive current, 90 degrees out of phase, so it's not really contributing to power, but there's about 100 milliamps of current flowing in this wire. And by running it backwards through the current transformer, I'm subtracting this little bit of current from this larger amount of current. And so let's go see if that makes a difference. I'll button this back up and then we'll plug it in the wall and see if the reading on the meter is any different. Yeah, YouTube, looks like that helped on the current reading. I'm now getting about 10 milliamps of no load current versus 100 that I was getting before. The only difference I see is the power is now reading 1.2 watts. So I'm thinking that capacitive dropper supply in the meter going through the current transformer is somehow registering as a little bit of power. Not sure. I've tried running the wire through different directions and off of different sides of the outlet. If you run it through the transformer, you get about 1 watt. If you go around the transformer, you get 0 watts, but you get higher residual current. Okay, now I wanted to show you one other thing here. I'll turn on my MIG welder again, MillerMatic 175. There we go. And before I changed that meter wire, I was getting about 44 watts. So now it's reading a little bit higher, but the interesting thing is the current is now actually reading higher. It was 0.27 or 270 milliamps. It's now 350. I think what's going on, that meter right there has a 1 microfarad capacitor that's the capacitive dropper that's in this power supply. That capacitor is supplying power factor correction to the load. So when I was running with the wire for the meter going outside of the current transformer, I was measuring the only part of the current. So part of the current was coming from that capacitor over to the plug, and the other part was coming in through the power line. So that 1 microfarad capacitor was providing about 80 milliamps of power factor correction. Now that I run that wire back through the current transformer, I'm subtracting that power factor correction out, and then I'm seeing the actual real current that's going to the load. The current reading is definitely more accurate. I think the power reading is just going to be off by that 1 watt. In fact, if you plug in the numbers here, if I take that 247 volts and I take the 0.36 or 0.37 amps and divide that by the 45 watts, you come up with about a 0.5 power factor on this welder when it's at idle. It could definitely use some power factor correction. And okay, I think that pretty much wraps up this first test of my 240 volt kilowatt meter. I think my next step, I want to pick up a few different adapters to work with the other 240 volt devices I have. Most of mine use this 20 amp plug, NEMA 6-20P, but I've got a couple of things that use a slightly different plug, so I want to see if I can find adapters for that. So I need the male to female to plug in there, and then I need the female to male to plug into the other end. So I need to get matching sets of adapters to be able to swap this around. I had a few subscribers ask to demonstrate the power alarm on this meter. I'll shoot that in a separate video since it's kind of unrelated to the main testing. Stay tuned for that video. If you have any questions, post up in the comment section below the video description there. And if you haven't already done so, you might consider subscribing to the channel, link in the lower right corner. And as always, thanks for watching.